It's got to go down fast and clean.
Yeah. Sonny, with all due respect to the new way of doing business, this will surely establish your credibility.
Well, that's the point, Eric. They had their chance. Now Scully's group gets taken out quickly and neatly. No talk, no negotiation.
I want it over now.
Right.
We should not have to deal with this kind of trouble.
Hey, Harry.
Hi. Hi, Luke.
Hi.
Listen, sorry about the trouble at the house. I'm just glad nobody got hurt.
Yeah, nobody important.
Hi.
Hi. You gonna help us clean up the mess, Harry?
I don't think I followed.
Well, it's no matter. As long as you follow instructions from the kingpin.
Oh, how's Mrs.?
Not good, Harry.
Yeah, she's a hell of a shot.
Yeah, I'm alive to tell you that's true. Well,
God bless her. You take care, Luke.
Thanks, Harry.
Sonny, I'm on it.
Right. Laura's still pretty upset, huh?
Yeah. Lousy way to raise kid. Dirty, rotten business. My wife's had it. She's had enough of it.
Laura's got to be rocked. It was pretty intense for everybody.
Hey, not for everybody, Sonny. You and I made choices. We may have backed into them or been backed into some of them, but we made choices, active choices.
To be fair, you did not sign on for all these complications.
No. But I knew the possibility. I knew all the possibilities. You might say my wife knew the possibilities when she signed on for this ride. She sure as hell knew she wasn't in for any standard matrimonial situation.
Well, you're not a standard kind of guy.
Nope. Neither is she. That was part of the attraction, the mutual attraction. We're neither one of us standard material. We're not normal folks. Whatever that is. You know, we traveled the whole world together. We lived in 18 different countries by the time Lucky was 7 years old. I always wanted to travel. So did Laura. But we weren't tourists, see? We were fugitives. We were game. Hunted by Frank and the organization. And it was painful moving my wife and kid around in the middle of the night, never using our real names, always looking over our shoulder. But it was life. It was life. My life. When I took Frank out, I figured I'd finally be able to give Laura the life she wanted. I failed.
Doesn't mean you never will.
No, I like to think that, partner. But she gave up. See, this house that we bought here, this home that she's so proud of, it was supposed to be a safe zone. Safe from fear, safe from violence. And last night, hell came crashing through the front door and left bullet holes in the wall.
Yeah, well, you know, there aren't any bullet holes in any of you.
I drink to that. The only reason I ain't laying on a slab in the morgue is because my wife blew a man away with a shotgun. Because he was about to kill me. And you and I will never know what that cost her. We can't. I think she's entitled to a bad reaction.
bad, is it?
It's bad enough that she said she wanted me to leave, and she meant it. I didn't argue. I didn't try to talk her down. I did what she asked. I left.
Well, man, I'm sorry, you know. Hey, man, you know, maybe she'll change her mind.
Yeah, maybe she will. Maybe she will, maybe she will. Listen, meantime, my wife and kids are alone in the house. I told Lucky. Sonny.
Yeah?
I told Lucky these guys would be too busy to come back.
I will see to it that's the case.
Good. Now, Garcia left a couple of cops watching the house, but I don't know how long they're going to be there, and I don't trust them anyway. I would like four of your best men watching my house 24 hours a day.
Absolutely. What's next for you?
I just give my wife some room and let her figure it out. So, what happened upstairs?
Oh, man, you know, let her...
Sorry.
Sorry, I damaged the bathroom.
The bathroom?
Yep.
How's Brenda?
Shaking, asking a lot of questions.
She getting wise?
Well, she figured out there's more to this than Joe wanting a piece of the club.
How you gonna handle that?
I don't know. Still kind of a delicate situation.
Stone.
I wish I knew. He just ran off. Nobody's seen him since.
Hopefully he's laying low.
Or worse.
Bad. Real bad, but he was walking.
Yeah, I mean, you know, he was when he left. One more thing. Robin was with him.
Oh, God.
No. She wasn't hurt. She's all right. But you can bet Max Scorpio will be asking a lot of questions.
Wonderful.
Hey, man. How you doing?
Always, from the beginning, I've always tried to do what was right for my wife and my family as I saw it.
That's all any of us can do.
You know, from the very beginning, I've had this feeling in my gut, this really sick feeling, that one day my wife would wake up and see the whole picture. And that's what happened this morning. What happened this morning was light in dark places. Lucas Lorenzo Spencer, fully illuminated. Oh, what the hell am I gonna do now?
How much you want to know?
Bare minimum, pal. I guess basically two things. Are we under control, and shall I expect any further fallout?
Yes and no.
Okay.
I wouldn't go making a public spectacle of myself the next few days. I'd wait this out till it all blows over.
Right. I better get back to the trenches.
Keep me posted.
Yeah. See you, Harry.
I'm glad you're here, Luke. I got, there's a personal matter on the table. And, I'd like to resolve it right now.
What happened to you? Nothing that a big old splashy fairy tale wedding won't fix. When are we leaving? Can you tell me what happened to you? I had visitors, Lois. I had visitors over at Sonny's house. I was home alone, and they came in with guns. Come on, let's start from the beginning, okay? Who was shooting at you? Joe Scully's men. I guess they were looking for Sonny, right? Yeah, it's probably a safe assumption. Tell me what happened. I was taking a shower, and it, just when I started to relax, I got this really strange feeling, and I turned around. Someone started shooting at me. Sweet mother. And it wasn't even like in Puerto Rico, Lois, where I was nosing around in something that wasn't any of my business. You know, I was in my own home. I was minding my own business. I was just taking a shower. I mean, how much more vulnerable can you be? And someone was just shooting at me. I've never been so scared in my whole entire life. I really thought that I was dead.
And where the hell was Sonny in all this?
Sonny was dealing with the same thing over at Luke's house.
You mean to tell me that there's some sort of war going on out there and Sonny's in the middle of it? What does he have to say for himself?
What do you think he has to say for himself? It's not his fault. Oh, he's sorry. All the stuff he's been saying to me, all the stuff I've heard before.
And what's your reaction to this?
I just don't believe it anymore. I don't believe it, Lois. It's old and it's tired. You know, the whole time that Joe was hanging out at Luke's club, Sonny was saying that it was because he wanted a piece of Luke's club. But it's ridiculous, because I know that people just don't go bursting into people's bathrooms and start shooting at them because of some stupid nightclub. Especially if the person who supposedly wanted the nightclub is dead. What's going on?
I'd like to hear the answer to that one myself.
I hope you accept my apology. When you and I first threw in together after Frank Smith, I never thought...
Hey, wait a minute. Forget that. It happens.
Whatever. The point is, you and I had a deal. I promised you that if anything ever came down on your family, that I would back out of the club, right? Well, I'm ready to say, you know, hey, man, I stand by my word.
Is that so?
It is so.
It's an awful lot of cash to come up with.
Hey,
you know,
Hey, man, cash, no cash. We'll take that out of the back end. All you got to say to me, right, is whatever, and I'm history.
I really appreciate that. I appreciate somebody who stands behind their word. But... No, I think we'll leave it as it is.
Why is that? Not that I've been planning.
What's the point, Sonny? Dissolving our partnership won't link us any less in the eyes of the bad guys. And besides, I've sort of built up my own animosity for this crowd. As far as you're concerned, I kind of like having you around. I'm afraid we might be stuck with each other.
Hey, man. Works for me. Still partners?
Still partners.
All right.
Thanks.
Ned. Oh, man, is he gonna be ticked or what? He has been predicting something like this all along while I've been bending over backwards defending Sonny and defending him.
Tell me about it.
Completely unacceptable. Sonny owes us some answers. I'm gonna go get them right now.
I'm gonna come with you.
No, you're not. This is between me and Sonny. I want you to stay here, okay? You all right? You lock the door behind me. Excuse me. If this were 15 years ago and we were in Bensonhurst, I'd ask you to spit and swear to the truth. It's like a blood oath, Corinthos.
Yeah, so?
So? So you tell me, what's to prevent L&B from getting mixed up in this trouble you brought down on this club and Luke?
See, that's Ashton talking. Did he send you...
Come on, no, you know me better than that. Sonny! I thought I knew you better than that. That's why I've been defending you to Ned all these months. But I am sure that he has read the afternoon papers by now. In fact, I expect him to be waiting for me back at the gatehouse when I get home. So what am I going to say, huh? Huh?
Well, whatever.
Even Brenda's starting to doubt you.
Did she say that?
She wants some answers, and so do I. I mean, why shouldn't any of us connected with you be scared to death after what happened last night?
It won't happen again.
That's what you said before.
But I can guarantee it.
Why? Huh? Because you're bigger and badder and meaner than whoever it was that sprayed bullets all over this place last night.
Because certain people finally got the message, I won't play their game. This was their big effort. Now they've taken the little marbles and gone home.
All right. You know what? You understand this, okay? If that's true, that's great. If not, we're quits. I'll be taking Ashton up on his offer to buy you out. You give me any grief, I'm taking the L out of L&B, and you and Brenda can run this company. That is if she doesn't walk out on you too.
Hi.
Hey, hi,
Amy. He is chomping at the bit to see you.
Is he doing okay?
He's recovering nicely. How are you doing?
I'm okay. I just got a few scratches.
Okay. Go ahead.
Thanks.
Hiya, gorgeous.
Hi.
Hey, what happened to you?
How do you feel about people trying to kill you?
They hit Sonny's apartment, the Spencer house, and the outside of the club simultaneously?
Yeah, it looks that way.
That's a lot of firepower.
Tell me about it. You weren't the one inside that shower. I was really scared.
What the hell's going on?
I don't know. I was hoping that you might know.
Look, I'm nothing more than an employee as far as Sonny's concerned. And if anyone has the inside track, it's you.
Sonny says that this is retaliation for Joe Scully's death and because he's gone legitimate. And he says that sooner or later, these people are going to get the message.
Sounds to me like they're the ones sending the message.
Exactly. I mean, why would these people go to all this trouble just because Sonny's gone legitimate, just because he won't play ball? Unless...
Unless what?
Unless it's the other way around. What if Sonny's the one running the game? What if Sonny's involved in organized crime still?
Joe wanted a piece of the club because he wanted a piece of me. He figured he could handle me. But these new people, they could care less about a couple of small, legitimate ventures.
You know, Sonny, this reminds me of a story my pops likes to tell. He and my ma were in Florida visiting Grandma and Grandpa Cirillo, you know, and they were all in the ocean. My pops sees this barracuda. This guy tells him don't sweat it because Florida barracudas never attack humans. So my father, he feels really reassured, you know, until he starts to think to himself, what if this is a Cuban barracuda and he doesn't know the local ground rules?
What do you want me to tell you, Lois?
Brenda could be dead right now. Not to mention Luke and Lucky, Stone, Robin, you, me, Ned, Miguel, Mary May, and Lord knows who else.
I'm telling you, it's over.
I don't think Spick covers it this time, Sonny.
Okay. There's only one way to prove it to you, right? That's if nothing happens. Why don't we give it 6 months? If there's any trouble, I will pull out of L&B. No strings.
It's not like a money-back guarantee on a stereo. If you're wrong, someone's very likely to end up dead.
I know. When there's danger, I told Brenda to get out of that apartment. She wouldn't listen. But I'm telling you right now, it's over. Everybody's safe.
You're jerking me around, Sonny.
You're gonna see trouble that'll make Joe Scully's boys look like pussycats.
Jerk around a Cirillo? I'm no fool.
Far from it.
Consider what I stand to lose. The Quartermains do business with me. I get respect. I'm not hurting financially either. And I got Brenda, who is as much a part of me as my arms and my legs. And then there's you, my friend. I'm giving you my word, and I will keep that. Do we have a deal?
6 months.
Well, we'll be hanging together longer than that. But for now, 6 months.
Admittedly, I do have some experience with disorganized crime, sad to say, but the organized variety is out of my league.
Mike, do you have any reason to think that Sonny is involved in anything other than L&B or Luke's club?
No. No. I mean, if anything, the way things turned out with Scully might be evidence that Sonny's on the side of the angels.
Time to let this man rest.
Okay. Thanks, Mike.
I wasn't much help.
What is your gut feeling?
I have so many gut feelings when my son is concerned, it's hard to sort them out. But, I mean, about this, I honestly don't know. One way or the other.
You get everything straight with Lois?
More or less.
Oops, better batten down. There's another wave hitting the beach.
Hey. How you doing?
Fine.
Where you been, sweetheart?
I was just at the hospital visiting Mike.
Mike?
Yeah, I remember him.
Did you tell him what happened?
I told him as much as I know.
I'll visit him tomorrow. Listen, can you keep an eye on this wake for the rest of the night?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks. I got my own tsunami to deal with.
Hey, sweet. So, you went to Lois?
Yeah, I went to Lois. She's my friend. And she's also my partner.
Yeah, well, she's my friend and my partner. But you got her bent out of shape for nothing.
For nothing? I don't really consider people trying to kill me nothing.
That's
Sonny.
Not what I meant. You know, I tell you, it's over. When are you going to learn to trust me?
Maybe when I'm not being shot at in my own shower.
Who was too stubborn to move to the Port Charles Hotel for a few days?
It's so interesting to me that I see it as me loving you enough to stick by your side, and you see it as me being stubborn.
Call it what you like. Every time we do things your way, it gets dicey. Like Puerto Rico, like last night.
Is there anything else that you want to blame on me right now, Sonny?
Yeah, yeah. The tone of this conversation.
Well, too bad.
Listen to me, okay? When I tell you that it's safe, you have to believe that it's safe.
Sonny, I'm scared. And here you are once again pretending like this is some video that we've just rented and that we can return and forget about.
It's over.
Yeah, right, until next time.
There is no next time.
You don't know that.
See, there you go. You're not trusting me again.
What, you mean not being a good little girl again, Sonny? Right, I was supposed to keep my mouth shut and not ask too many questions?
Do we have a problem?